Barcelona and Messi punished Sevilla, Bayern Munich and Borussia destroyed their rivals in the Bundesliga, and meanwhile Chelsea decided to thwart Real's plans for Holland. Friends, yesterday's football day certainly didn't get us disappointed. Lots of heated matches, results and news. Want to be aware of all things mentioned? Then you are to subscribe to our channel. Guys, who do you think will get the European Golden Boot 2021? Share your predictions in the comments below. And while you're writing, we'll proceed to start off. Let's get going! Lionel Messi scored in his 8th consecutive La Liga game. Getting old? No way! Real Madrid intends to sell Rafael Varane this summer, as the Frenchman doesn't agree to renew the contract, which expires in the summer of 2022. Manchester City now has 20 consecutive victories in all tournaments. Guardiola's team is incredible! For the first time, Serie A referee will be interviewed on TV. This person will be Daniele Orsato. It should be very interesting. Leipzig will be open for sale this summer for goalkeeper Peter Gulacsi and midfielder Marcel Sabitzer, Bild says. Juventus is keen to land Arkadiusz Milik and Memphis Depay in the next transfer window. If Messi comes to play in MLS, I would kiss his feet, claimed Dallas striker Franco Jara in an interview with 90 Min. AC Milan follows Lille winger Jonathan Ikoné. David Alaba in Real Madrid? I don't know anything about it. Didn't communicate with him. He himself is able to make a decision. Bild quotes Toni Kroos. The Barcelona midfielder Pedri suffered a muscle injury in the game against Sevilla. He will miss 2-3 weeks. Galatasaray will make an offer to PSG midfielder Julian Draxler in the upcoming days. In the summer, the German will be in a free agent status. Burnley could release its goalkeeper Nick Pope for 58 million euros. Tottenham is interested in him. Ousmane Dembele has scored for Barcelona in La Liga for the first time since last year's December. The Frenchman's goalless streak lasted for 9 matches. Cristiano Ronaldo's girlfriend Georgina Rodriguez appeared on the cover of Sport Week. She is gorgeous as always. I get goosebumps when I think about the national team. My door will always be open to Italy, said Inter coach Antonio Conte in the interview with Il Corriere della Sera. Atletico are set to revive their interest in Tottenham playmaker Giovanni Lo Celso. Guardiola has got his 200th win at the head of Manchester City and the 500th in his coaching career. Inter president Steven Chan intends to sell the club after the end of the 2020-21 season, reported Corriere dello Sport. Robert Lewandowski scored 14 goals in 14 appearances for Bayern Munich in 2021. That's Polish's perfect result. Harry Kane won't leave Tottenham for the summer transfer window. Within the conditions of the economic crisis, no club can afford to sign the Englishman, informs The Telegraph. Borussia Mönchengladbach midfielder Florian Neuhaus has no plans to leave the club, despite Liverpool's interest. At the age of 20, Jadon Sancho became the youngest player in history to make 50 assists in the Bundesliga. Kevin De Bruyne provided his 77th assist in the Premier League and made it to the top 10 in the ranking of that league. Many interesting matches took place yesterday in the main European championships. The latest results are right in front of you. And now it's time for us to dive into the main news of the release. Let's talk briefly about Saturday's matches. In the Premier League, Manchester City were stronger than West Ham. Pep Guardiola's team beat the Hammers at Etihad with 2-1 and secured their 20th victory in a row in all tournaments. The Citizens continue to head the Premier League table with 62 points in 26 match days. In La Liga, Barcelona dealt with Sevilla in an away match, 2-0. Ousmane Dembele opened the scoreline in the 29th minute of the meeting. And then the matter turned into continuous tackles and fights, which were thwarted by yellow cards for the players of both teams. Even Lionel Messi nearly crossed the line. At the end of the first half, the Barca captain received a yellow card for a foul on Fernando. And a couple of minutes later, he risked seeing a red card in front of him for an outright foul on Jules Kounde. Sevilla's head coach Julen Lopetegui demanded from Alejandro Hernandez, the referee, to immediately send off the Argentine from the pitch, but he did a completely different thing. A yellow card to the Red Whites coach and no punishment for Messi. Interestingly enough, that on the 85th minute it was Lionel who killed the intrigue in the match. And whilst admiring Leo's game, Sevilla midfielder Juan Jordan tried his best to get his shirt. But it didn't work out though. In general, Messi's second goal helped the Catalans get in their 9th victory in the last 10 match days of the Spanish championship. By the way, we can't stop following the progress of the 18-year-old Barcelona talent ILAIX MORIBA. The boy once again got a chance from Ronald Koeman and thanked the coach after the match. Well, of course, there was praise from Messi. After a triumph against Sevilla, Barcelona have moved up to second place in La Liga table, but Real, which is going next in the ranking, still has a game in hand. Now let's switch on to the Bundesliga. Here we had a scoring extravaganza. Bayern smashed Köln 5-0, while Borussia nailed 3 unanswered goals to Armenia. And yet the most exciting match of the day was played by far not from Munich and not from Dortmund. The clash between Leipzig and Borussia Mönchengladbach was there to show their real intrigue. The guests, thanks to the efforts of Jonas Hofmann and Marcus Thuram, scored 2 goals by the 19th minute of the match and kept the gap until the first half break. But after a 15-minute pause, a completely different Leipzig entered the pitch. The precise shots from Christopher Nkoko, Yusuf Poulsen and Alexander Sørloth brought the team of Julian Nagelsmann a heroic victory. Thus, Bayern remain at the top of the league, but Leipzig is breathing down the necks of the champions of Germany. Borussia Dortmund, meanwhile, is again approaching the Champions League zone. Next up, Serie A. Juventus lost points in the game against Verona 1-1. Torrance's performance was very cranky, but Cristiano Ronaldo somehow found a chance to score. In the 49th minute of the match, the Portuguese finished the cross from Federico Chiesa and netted his 19th goal in the current Italian championship run. The unnecessary misfire on an away fixture means that Juve remains in third place and runs the risk of missing out the Scudetto again and again with each match day. In Liga 1, PSG steamrolled the championship outsider Dijon. Moise Kean's goal, Kylian Mbappe's brace and Danilo Pereira's shot from the standard position was enough for a big victory 4-0. After this match, the Parisians were placed on the second place in the table, although their main competitors will still play their matches today. Now the team of Maurizio Pochettino will hope for the losses of Lyon and Lille. Barcelona striker Lionel Messi is increasingly leaning towards extending his contract with the Catalan club, according to Marca. Following the details from the source, the Argentine hasn't yet made any decision about his future career. Messi really wanted to leave the Camp Nou when Josep Maria Bartomeu was the president of the club, but after the sacking of the functionary, the forward decided that he would consider any options. Lionel is currently thinking about signing a new contract with Barca. Moreover, the Blaugrana's leader intends to refuse PSG, which doesn't hide its interest in the 33-year-old footballer. Messi is increasingly irritated by rumors about his future and recent comments from the French club. We are to know that PSG's sporting director Leonardo and head coach Maurizio Pochettino publicly hinted that the Red Blues would try to get Lionel in the summer as a free agent, and the local media didn't hesitate to post images of the player wearing the Parisian team uniform. Marca knows that Messi really didn't like the activity of PSG, so he and his father Jorge haven't yet conducted any negotiations in this direction. It is expected that Lionel will take the final decision on his future after the election of the new president of Barcelona, which will take place on March 7. A serious new contender for Erling Haaland has arrived. Chelsea owner Roman Abramovich will allocate £225 million to head coach Thomas Tuchel to bolster his squad for the summer transfer window, reports German Sport 1. The Russian businessman wants the pensioners to use this money to sign Borussia Dortmund striker Erling Haaland, whose game style Abramovich actually admires. It is worth noting that Chelsea is not going to wait for the summer of 2022, when the Norwegian striker can be purchased for £75 million only. It is the buyback option written in Haaland's contract that will become available for the top clubs in a year. Now Borussia doesn't intend to release Erling for less than £100 million, although the London club apparently is ready to satisfy even that demand of the Hornets. Oh yeah, an important addition to the news. In addition to Haaland, Chelsea decided to buy his teammate Jadon Sancho, whose value is rapidly falling against the backdrop of the economic crisis in football caused by the coronavirus pandemic. Borussia can sell the 20-year-old Englishman for £88 million, which is significantly lower than the £130 million that the Germans demanded from Manchester United last summer. It looks like Abramovich is ready to break all competitors with his grand scheme. Somewhere in Madrid, a Florentino Perez started to look a bit nervous. Friends, we offer you an interesting video about Neymar on the Inside Football channel. Give it a try for yourself. Stay tuned to our football news channel. Thanks everyone for watching. Have a nice one and see you in a bit.